Hey everybody, this is Michael again, and welcome back to my channel here on YouTube. Well everyone, tonight's film, as you know, is my thoughts on The Force Awakens. And I know the film, you know, been out in the theaters, it's gone now, been a while. Many of you may be wondering why I haven't talked about this movie, and I haven't really explained it. I mean, you know, a lot of people, and I mean a lot, have requested from me to hear my thoughts on this movie. Why haven't I done it already? You know, if you follow my channel, you probably know that I'm a big Star Wars fan. Why have I not discussed this film at all after all this time? I mean, it's pretty much practically on home video now. Well, you know, it's a real easy question to me, guys. I mean, two things, basically. With the number one thing being that, you know, I saw this film in the theater actually on opening day. And I was just really, really torn from this film. I was really, really hurt, guys. I felt betrayed by this movie. I just expected so much more than what we got. And it was really hurtful to me. Now, you know, I know some of you are probably saying, oh, it's just a movie. Well, I'll go into that a little bit later. So, you know, I was hurt from the film. I was just disgusted with the movie, did not even want to talk about the movie, I was just so disappointed. And secondly, you know, by the time the film rolled out, everybody and their dog started giving their opinion on the film, and there was a lot of rants on the film, there was a lot of people defending the film, you know, just, you know, regular everyday things with movies, you know, rants, defending, hardcore fans, fanboys, you know, and I just got tired of hearing about the damn movie, so I just didn't want to talk about it. I was disgusted with the movie, and I just didn't want to talk about it. And to be honest, guys, I even told a couple of people, The Force Awakens, I'm not going to talk about this film. I don't want to give my thoughts on this movie. I'm just so disgusted with this film. I just don't want to talk about it. I have nothing really good to add to my thoughts on this movie. But I've been asked so many times, I'm like, okay. Now, first of all, guys, I don't want to take away any of you guys' enjoyment from the movie. I'm not going to rant on the movie. And you know me, guys, I don't really rant anyway. But I don't know what my opinion can add to all the other opinions out there about this movie. But I decided to watch the film again tonight. You know, so it'd be fresh in my mind. Perhaps I'd have a different opinion of the movie. Now, I do have pros and cons on the movies, guys. There's things I did like about the film. I liked it visually. I thought visually it was just a really beautiful movie. Secondly, I liked the actors. I think the actors did a really credible job. I liked Rey and Finn. I thought that they had a good relationship together and they had some genuine chemistry. Then I liked seeing, you know, the original series actors. It was, you know, when I first saw the film in the theater, I got a little bit emotional when I saw Han Solo and Chewbacca and some of the original series characters. But, you know, overall, guys, that's about it. That's about all I liked about this movie. And, you know, I had mentioned earlier that I did not want to talk about this movie because I felt so hurt and betrayed. I'm a fan of the original series, guys. A fan of the original series of movies. Love those films. Grew up with those films. Luke Skywalker, legendary character. You knew at the end of Return of the Jedi that he was going to go on to great things. He's going to raise the Jedi back. He's going to bring just this force of powerful Jedis to battle for good and fight against evil. You just knew that he and Leia would become the remaining two Jedis that would start a whole new organization. And of course, you know, by this film, none of that happened. And what really makes me feel betrayed the most is the fact that, you know, we watch Luke from a teenager to The Empire Strikes Back to Return of the Jedi. We watch him grow up. We watch him become the badass that he was in Return of the Jedi. And, you know, by this film, 30 years later, Luke has tried to bring back the Jedi Order. One of his students ends up destroying everything that he built. And Luke is so emotionally distraught that he runs away and hides in a cave. That is the ultimate betrayal of this character. That's tragic. It just pisses me off more than anything that we have this iconic character that when the going gets tough, he runs his ass away into a cave and hides. And you know, that's just enough for me, guys. That's what I could not talk about this film because I just felt so betrayed by that. Everything that this character was, three films based upon this character who's a kid, who grows and learns, becomes powerful, and in this fucking movie, he runs and hides in a fucking cave, leaves everybody that he loves at the hands of the First Order, doesn't care who dies, doesn't care to find out what kind of trouble they are. It's like, oh my God, I failed, I'm gonna run and freaking hide. You know, J.J. Abrams claims to be a huge fan of Star Wars, but I gotta ask myself, why the fuck would he do this to this character? It just pisses me off, guys, because there's so many avenues that they could have done when they made this film. So many avenues. I mean, they could have actually had Luke and Leia become Jedi and restore the Jedi Order. There's so many places the story could have been taken. But they chose to play it safe and basically rehash all the elements in the original Star Wars film, or as they're known now, Episode 4. So you see, guys, we tend to get a little attached to movies, you know? I'm not impervious to that. I get attached to a film, too. And, you know, you get invested in these characters. And, you know, and honestly, guys, you start to love these characters. You start to personalize these characters, become a part of your world, and, you know, you invest in these characters. And honestly, guys, I think the character of Luke Skywalker was shit on. I think he was shit on as a character. And, you know, making him just run away, leaving everybody he loves to die or at the hands of the First Order, not giving one rat's ass, it's just character assassination, guys. And that's the main reason I just felt betrayed and did not want to talk about this movie because, you know, I expected to see this powerful Jedi Knight, this teacher, who was just, you know, kick-ass. And, you know, even that in itself, guys, you know, the guy comes in, kills all of Luke's students, ruins everything that he's built, and, you know, there's no personal responsibility by Luke fucking Skywalker at all. I mean, you know, put yourself in his place. Okay, I'm going to start the new Jedi Order. I'm going to rebuild this organization. Okay, we start it, we rebuild it. One of my students goes fucking apeshit and kills everybody. What am I going to do? Well, naturally, I'm going to go run and hide. No, what I'm going to do is say, this is my fault. I'm responsible for this. I'm going to put an end to this. I'm going to get my lightsaber and get my happy ass over there and stop him. So it's like, yeah, I started this new order. The guy's going batshit crazy. He killed everybody. I'm out of here, dude. Game over, man. Game over. Leia, you're on your own there, buddy. I mean, you know, I just don't understand. I understand people like films. I can understand people like this movie, and I'm not discrediting how they feel about it. But how can you guys accept that? Character assassination, man. How can you accept the fact that Luke Skywalker fucking left everything after he fucked up, apparently? How can you accept that? How can you respect him as a character? How can you look at him in the same light? Oh, well, you know, he's human, so, you know, we make mistakes, you know, but, yeah, you know, really? We're gonna chalk it up. It's just, you know, he had an emotional breakdown and just had to get away. Yeah. Yeah. Hey, what did you do today, Luke? Well, you know, I was training these guys, and one of them went crazy, killed everybody, and I took a trip to Bermuda. So, you know, these things happen. So, you know, I could sit here and pinpoint just so many things about the story that, you know, just makes no sense, guys. But it's all been covered already. You know, what can I add to it, guys? You know, that's why I like to say my thoughts on a movie. Because this is my thoughts, guys. That's the biggest sin of the entire movie. Now, of course, the second biggest sin is just retreading old avenues. Why did we have to have a story which basically retells page by page of the script from A New Hope? Why did we need that? Oh, well, he just wanted to, you know, just play it safe to bring new people in and introduce them to the trilogy. Really? That's the excuse? I think it would have been much braver to go another route. I mean, honestly, guys, do you really think that this film with the name Star Wars on it would have failed if he'd done a different story? Do you really believe that? I don't. I just think they didn't have the balls to write something original, and J.J. Abrams loved the original film so much that he just worshipped every freaking page of the script and thought, well, let's see, we'll need a character like Luke. Let's make a character like that. Hey, let's make it a female character. But what about R2-D2? Oh, we'll make another robot that's kind of like him. I mean, it's just a retread of Star Wars. You know, I want Star Wars to be successful because I like the Star Wars films. But guys, this film made $1 billion. I'm actually sitting back there thinking, why? Why? Why did it make $1 billion? I mean, it's almost like that stigma, you know, whenever a horror film comes out. Oh, this was the scariest horror film that's been out in 10 years. Oh, people were fainting in the aisles. Oh, this guy threw up. I mean, it's just like every time a freaking movie comes out, you know, that has a decent marketing budget, just people go nuts. And, you know, I just don't understand it. I mean, you know, a true Star Wars fan to me that can accept the fact that Luke Skywalker turned his back on everything that we know of him as a character. I can't accept it, guys. I can't accept it. It just does more harm than good to me. How can they redeem this character after what they did to him? And then the whole thing with Leia. Leia's a general in the military. A general in the resistance. 30 years, a general in the resistance. I mean, you know, possibly I'm wrong, but it was my understanding or my force that she would become a military leader. But not only that, but she would also become a force user. No signs of her using the force. I don't think the lady's ever picked up a lightsaber, man. I don't even think she's ever lit a cigarette. And disappointing, guys. Luke, there is another. That boy is our last hope. There's another, but she's still sitting there behind electronic tables plotting strategy. So, you know, that's another element of the original series that was totally tossed out the window. And just too many conveniences in the film for me, guys. Rey just able to fly the Millennium Falcon after, you know, practicing on flight simulators, more or less. Rey actually being able to handle the Force and become a Force yielder, Force user, able to fight someone that's fully trained. I mean, guys, it's like, what the fuck is going on with the Force? You know, is the Force just so enhanced? Is something guiding this into this chick that's just making her so strong? And then people are like, well, yeah, they're going to be kick-ass in the second movie because Luke's going to come and he's going to train her and she's going to be really tough. What the fuck? She might need to train Luke. I sure have a very, very strong feeling that she wouldn't have fucking ran away and left her friends. What can Luke teach her? It took him 3 movies to hone all his skills. This chick learned it in a few days. I mean, guys, you know, I just feel like, you know, we have Luke Skywalker, who has pretty much been assassinated in this movie. We have Leia, who, you know, was also in the original series of films, and you know, strong character, always very, very strong. And she's pretty much, you know, on the sidelines in this movie. She doesn't really do anything. And then we have Han Solo, who's pretty much the same character that we saw 30 years ago. There's no growth to any of these characters. And I noticed that immediately, and I watched it. I'm like, this has been 30 years, and we're basically watching the very same characters that we watched in the original trilogy. They have not went anywhere. You know, it's like Abrams is just going out of his way to get rid of the original series characters. Now, granted, Harrison Ford has always wanted Han Solo to die. Hates playing the guy, always have. Wanted George Lucas to kill him. You know, sometimes I think a director should override what an actor wants. I mean, because Sigourney Weaver wanted Ripley to die, we got that dreadful Alien 3. Now, you know, Harrison Ford approached George Lucas and said, you know, I want to die in this movie. Lucas said, no. Why do we have to kill off Han Solo in this movie? Well, because Ben died in the original film. We have to have a character die because, you know, Ben Kenobi died. So let's kill Han Solo. I mean, it's just like there's not really much respect given to the older characters. I mean, we can borrow nearly all the elements from the original film, but we're going to treat all the original series characters like shit and make them play second fiddle to these new characters. I mean, Abrams is like, yeah, this is my Star Wars film. It's going to be bigger and better. Oh, we had Luke, but I'm going to have, she's going to be strong. She's going to be able to use the Force in a matter of 2 hours. I mean, she's going to kick ass. You know, if Emperor Palpatine was here, you know, a little bit of arrogance, he would sit there and be like, you know, Luke Skywalker failed the Jedi Order. He put his tail between his legs and ran. He is of no threat. Snoke, we gotta get Luke Skywalker. We can't let him be found. He's the last Jedi. He'll be able to, that dude didn't do shit. He ran. Why is he such a big fucking threat? He ran. And even if he comes back, Rey knows more than he knew in 3 fucking movies. What is the big threat with Luke Skywalker? I love the character, but the dude fucking ran. I mean, he's a coward. He put his lightsaber between his legs and ran. And the whole film is based around finding him. And Luke's like, oh, I'm gonna, you know, run away, but I'm gonna tease him a little. I'm gonna put a little map in R2, and then I'm gonna put a little map here, and we're gonna play Easter and find eggs throughout the galaxy. It just makes very, very little sense to me, guys. I mean, if you don't want to be found, you don't leave a map, okay? So, you know, guys, I just, you know, granted, guys, the prequels aren't perfect movies by any stretch of the word. But one thing that's really great about the films that George Lucas were a part of is that they were different. The first film, Desert Planet. Second film, The Ice World of Hoth. Third film, Jungle Setting. And then in the prequels, just all kind of outrageous settings and spaceships and technology. Now, one thing that I thought was really kind of neat about The Force Awakens. One thing that I thought was really neat about the prequels is that they expanded on the Star Wars universe. I mean, you know, guys, you can say it all day, but the original film trilogy showed a very, very limited scope on, you know, the Star Wars universe, but the prequels just, you know, really blew it open. You know, they had a lot of weaknesses, but they did expand the Star Wars universe. I mean, we got to see Jedi in their prime. We got to see, you know, the prequels are definitely hit and miss, but there's a lot of good things about the prequels also, you know. It's easy to sit back and bash them, you know, and say, oh, that sucked. But at the same time, there's a lot of good things in the prequels. Shoot me now, okay? But I would have respected J.J. Abrams much more. Well, I would have respected him, period, if they had went a different route, did a service to these characters, and just, you know, brave enough to tell a different story instead of a recycled story. Why recycle? Yeah, Star Wars is great. We don't need another Star Wars. We need something original. Let's show the repercussions of what happened in 30 years. Let's show what Leia went through all these years. Let's give a reason why she's still stuck there and didn't want to become a Jedi Knight. Let's show what happened with Luke and what he was doing. I mean, you know, you can't just wrap 30 years up by an opening scrawl and then, you know, a two-hour movie. Let's see what really happened in this 30 years. I would have much rather seen, you know, Luke start a new Jedi Order with Leia, some of his students turn, and, you know, and Luke being responsible, stepping up and saying, you know, I'm going to take charge, this is my fault, this is my fight. And, you know, at the end of Return of the Jedi, you kind of got the impression that, you know, things might be getting a little bit better. But by this film, everything went batshit crazy, and Luke's in a cave. Speaking of that cave, though, guys, you know, Ren walked all the way up to that cave. Why didn't you just fucking fly the Millennium Falcon up there? I was thinking, you know, why walk, man? Just fly up there. You don't need any exercise. You're force sensitive. But, you know, I didn't want to talk about this movie. I did not want to talk about this movie. I was just totally disappointed with this movie. Disappointed with what they did to the original series characters. Disappointed with the story. Oh, and don't even get me started on Kylo Ren. Just, you know, really? He stops a laser bolt with the Force. Okay. I've just had it. I'm just done. I don't want to get into I don't want to give my thoughts and just, you know, this I didn't like, you know, this, nitpick this and all this. I just don't like the film, guys. I mean, hopefully that's reason enough. I just think that it was a disgrace to what George Lucas has built in the original series, and I think it did a disservice to those films, and I think it makes all the events in Return of the Jedi, I just think they're a moot point now, because, you know, Luke, all this, you know, we've seen him train, struggle, and learn, and all this shit at the very end meant nothing. It did nothing. And his influence as a Jedi, you know, we still basically have the Empire and the Rebels. Empire has the best material. Don't even get me started on the new Starkiller base, a.k.a. Death Star. I mean, how safe can you play it? My goodness. But, you know, for you people out there, you few people out there that wanted to hear my thoughts on this movie, I'm going to tell you, I didn't want to talk about this film. I just, you know, just so disappointed with this movie that, you know, it was just a major letdown. And, you know, there are those films that, you know, I really feel majorly let down from, and I just don't like talking about them. You know, Man of Steel was one. I had really high hopes for that movie, but I just, you know, just got burned. Then we had, you know, Alien 3 that I mentioned. You know, I had high hopes for that film coming off Alien 2, and I just burned. Now, of course, we have Star Wars, which, you know, I'm just burned. But like I said, guys, if any of you liked it, all fine and dandy, but the movie is just not for me. I just did not like the way they treated the original characters. I didn't like how they basically copied the original plot to the original Star Wars film. You know, for every character that was in Star Wars, they had a character that was supposed to be a mirror, or is a mirror image of that character. Even down to the damn sand on Jakku. I mean, it just so much like the original Star Wars, even down to fighting the Death Star at the end of the movie. Just guys, I just, you know, I don't have a problem with the lead character being a woman. I don't have a problem with the lead character being strong. I don't have a problem with her being able to use a Force. But I mean, but from everything we've learned of Star Wars films thus far, you know, the Force is a gradual learning thing. Even Yoda, you know, 800 years of I trained Jedi. No, he's too old to begin the training. It's a gradual process where you learn and grow. But in this film, with no explanation given as to why this girl is able to just do all this stuff without any kind of mentorship. It just goes against everything that's established in Star Wars so far that came before it. And I just, it's almost like, you know, like I said, they just took a shit on the Star Wars in the past, just a shit on it. And they made their own film. They didn't give any kind of regard to what came before it. And I just think that's wrong. And I really got to give George Lucas props because, you know, after he saw the movie, he said, you know, they went for a retro kind of look. You know, they did a film that's been done. Basically, he said that, you know, I like to try things that's different. I like to try, you know, with each film, make things different. And, you know, that was really exciting about Star Wars. It was exciting to see. I mean, Hoth, an ice planet. When you saw that scene, it's like, wow, they live on this world? This can't be an easy place to live. I bet you they don't go outside and pee. I mean, you know, just something different. Visually, just exciting. And, you know, maybe people felt so burned by the prequels that they just, you know, saw this film, was like, oh, this is Star Wars. Oh, it felt like a Star Wars film. And I felt really, I had a shallow feeling in this movie, guys. I mean, who didn't see a mile away that Han Solo was going to meet his end in this movie? I mean, you know, I felt, you know, really shallow inside when I was watching this film. There are moments, guys, I got to tell you, that, you know, I felt, maybe smiled and enjoyed a few of the moments. But overall, whenever the film went into that recycled mode where I'm seeing things that I saw on the screen years and years ago from a movie I really enjoyed, what is there to love, guys? What is there to love when you're watching the exact same shit on screen that you've seen in another movie? What is there to love when you're watching these? I mean, you know, you experience these films. You live with these characters. What is there to love when the new film comes out and they shit all over Skywalker? He's a fucking coward. What is there to love? Why am I supposed to enjoy that? It, you know, another comparison. It's almost like, you know, James T. Kirk, played by William Shatner, this great, epic, legendary character. And then we have this other James T. Kirk in these newer films, thank you, Mr. Abrams, that, you know, a pale imitation. And what is the deal with J.J. redoing films that have already been done? So, you know, apologize for going off the edge there, guys. I never intended to. But I just, you know, if I really, really put my mind to it and I really, really think about it, I feel disgust. I feel anger. I feel disappointment. I feel betrayed on a universal scale with what Abrams has done with these characters, with this film. And I gotta be honest with myself and to you guys, because, you know, what's the point? I wish the movie hadn't been this successful. I wish it had failed, because to me, it failed. It has Star Wars name on it, but it has none of Star Wars spirit in it. And I just, you know, I mean, little thing, guy, like at the end of the film, after Han Solo is killed, Chewbacca goes straight past Leia, walks straight past her. You think the two would hug at least. I mean, it's like no disregard or no regard for the characters. Oh, we got new characters now. Let's focus on them. The hell with the original series characters. I don't know, guys. You know, at this point, I just don't know what they can do to redeem the character of Luke Skywalker, because, you know, I mean, I just felt like, you know, everything in this movie was pretentious. Everything was forced. I mean, and, you know, even though I liked Rey and Finn, both missed opportunities as characters, not very much depth as characters. As a matter of fact, you know, the Star Wars films, and I know somebody's going to say this, Star Wars films have never been really big on characterization. I mean, not so so much in depth, really. I mean, we've got to know their personalities, but they're never really been too deep of characters. But you know, the original Star Wars was mirrored after Saturday morning serial. So you know, you have, you know, action stories, these larger than life characters, and you know, on that level, it succeeded. But in this film, you know, it's since they chose to use the same story as the original Star Wars, everything just felt kind of forced, because you're watching it and you're thinking, well, we have to do this because that's what they did in the original Star Wars, so we have to do it. Which, you know, Rey, I don't dislike the character. I actually like the actress. I think she did a great job. I just felt like, you know, she went from point A, B, C, and D just a little bit too fast. And this whole thing with her parents staying on this planet waiting for her parents to come back is like, dude, you've been here for, what, 20-something years? They haven't come back yet. Why are you waiting here? I mean, and then Finn. I mean, we actually have a stormtrooper who just says, fuck it. I ain't doing it. Fuck it. That's your answer to everything. Fuck it. It's Richard Pryor and Gene Wilder there. I'm just crazy. But anyway, we have a stormtrooper, guys. I mean, we've always been taught in these films that stormtroopers just, you know, do what they're told. They take their job serious. I mean, we actually have a guy who's actually fighting the system. He's turning against it. He's not going to kill no more. And the film, you know, while you have that, you have a stormtrooper just saying no. I mean, the guy was kidnapped as a kid, been conditioned to be a stormtrooper all his life. And all we get out of that is, I didn't want to kill anymore. I couldn't do it. I'm not going to kill. Well, why not? You've been conditioned ever since you've been a kid, and that's the only reason that you decide to get out of this, you know? You know, for a guy who's been conditioned all his life and been told to do this, and, you know, you have the lead guy that's in control of the fleet and everything arguing with Kylo Ren, telling him, no, my men are conditioned. They don't fail and all this. You have Finn just, you know, happy-go-lucky, laughing, joking, having a fun time. That's the conditioning? I mean, you know, I could see Finn, you know, fighting, you know, the system, kind of struggling to become his own identity, you know? He's never been his own person. He's been told what to do all his life. There's no depression. There's no scars. There's no mental anguish. There's no, they told me to kill and I did it. I feel guilty. There's nothing. How could there be nothing? You've been doing this shit since you were a kid. I don't know how they condition them. Do they put them on the machine? Do they program them? Conditioned. And he is just like a normal, regular character. That would not be the case. Now, granted, I've never been conditioned. But I can only imagine that there would be some deep mental scars there. How would freedom really feel? I mean, you know, there's just no consequence as to this guy not being a stormtrooper anymore. There's nothing. I mean, that could have been a unique kind of perspective, a unique character. But nothing with Finn. I mean, you know, getting out is easy. And learning is half the fun. And I mean, and you know, there's just nothing to this, no depth to this character at all. You know, no bad dreams, no waking up in a cold sweat saying, I saw myself do this. Oh, well, he didn't kill anybody. He's been a stormtrooper all his life, but he's never killed anybody. You know, he's never killed anybody. So when did that exactly happen? Did he never kill anybody? He went out on his first mission. Was being down on Jakku, his jacuzzi, was that his first encounter? Was that his first time he was going to kill somebody? Because if that was the first time he was going to kill somebody, what the frack has he been doing all these years? Just taking out the trash? Do you really need to condition someone to work in sanitation? I mean, you pay a minimum wage, they'd probably do it. But so, you know, I mean, I like the character, but at the same time, there was just nothing realistic to him. Missed opportunity. Which, you know, pretty much sums up my whole thoughts on this film. It's a missed opportunity. A big fucking missed opportunity. Because there just could have been so many ways they could have taken this film, guys. So many ways they could have done this story. And, you know, people are going to argue with me and say, well, you know, you're not a Star Wars fan because, you know, guys, fine. If you like the movie, fine. Like the movie. But I'm sorry. I just cannot accept what they did to these characters. I cannot accept the fact that instead of being brave and bold, Star Wars, epic. Star Wars is known for being different, being bold, taking adventures, taking risk. This film just played it safe. I mean, you know, underlying theme from Disney. Well, first of all, you know, we're going to have those hardcore fans that's going to like the original characters, so we'll introduce them very quietly. But we're going to put our characters in the forefront. So let's introduce the new characters and then, you know, kind of just get rid of the old ones. I'm serious. I wouldn't be surprised if that was a mandate. I mean, you know, Empire Strikes Back came out. And, you know, I'm waiting for Luke to say, Rey, I am your father. I mean, you just, are we going to follow this? I mean, I don't know what they can do. Rey's getting, even Kylo Ren said it. We need to stop her now. She's discovering her power. She's getting stronger and stronger as time passes. What the fuck? Is she going to be a Force ghost by the second movie? I mean, what? Who's going to stop her? Who's going to stop her? Do we need a trilogy of films with this girl gaining strength this fast? I mean, you know, who's she going to fight? Snoke? Looked like somebody already slapped him upside the head with a lightsaber. But, I don't know, guys. I just don't know what the fuck they're doing. I'm not even sure they know what they're doing. I mean, does Abrams sit back and think, wow, I should have done this, I should have done that. I just don't get how you can sit there and write this stuff and someone not say, this is just like the first movie. Why are we just doing the first movie? What the? So, you know, I didn't want to talk about this movie, guys. I know I've said that like 3 or 4 times now. I didn't want to talk about this movie. It just, I just, you know, missed opportunity, guys. I just wished that they had done something else, you know, instead of virtually making, remaking the original film. You know, Force Awakens, all us old school fans, we wanted to see Luke Skywalker. Well, we do get to see him for about 30 seconds standing atop a mountain. Wow, that was really worth the price of admission. Now, you know, in hindsight, guys, is it the worst film I've ever saw? No, it's not the worst film I ever saw. But for me, on a personal level, it joins that list of films that I just, you know, if I had a most disappointed film list, this film would probably be in the top three. And I just don't like what J.J. Abrams did to Star Wars. I just do not like it, guys. I felt like these new characters are more important than the original characters. The goal is we gotta, you know, bring in the younger generation, so we need new characters. I mean, you know, at the very least, let's focus on the older characters and then introduce the new. Let's not just blindside the older characters that made the film series what it is and, you know, treat them like shit, more or less. So, that's my thoughts on the film, guys. You know, I'm a completist. I have all the Star Wars films on Blu-ray in that one set, and this one will join my collection of films. Just like I have Alien 3, and I really don't like that movie either. But I just, nothing like having a supervillain that, you know, gets mad and takes it out on the equipment in the ship that you're fucking living in. But anyway, you know, could you imagine Darth Vader doing that? Well, he did it with people, not equipment. Well, if you're going to, you know, take your frustration out, it's probably a little bit smart to take it out on the people instead of the technology that you're happening to be supporting your life. But, yeah, guys, I just, you know, I don't know. I just really feel Abrams fucked up is what he did. I think he had a total disregard of Star Wars. I don't think he understood, you know, these characters like he should have. I think he did a disservice to these characters. And, you know, I just was disappointed in this film. Just disappointed. So there you have it, guys. That's my thoughts on The Force Awakens. And, you know, honestly, I wish The Force had stayed asleep. Or that they'd have followed the original storyline. You know, years later, we have Luke in charge of a great new Jedi organization. And, you know, well, Luke went to find the Jedi Temple. What fucking for? But anyway, this is probably the closest you'll get as a rant to me. I haven't seen Batman versus Superman yet. And, you know, I've heard everything everybody said. I've read the reviews. And, you know, the first thing that pisses me off is why this ain't called Superman versus Batman. But anyway, love those two characters. Going to be seeing that film probably this weekend, probably. But I don't know, guys. I just, I don't know. But I am going to remain cautiously optimistic. But anyway, thanks for watching, everybody. You know, long awaited. I hope I didn't offend anybody too much. Nothing personal at all. It's all movies, guys. It's nothing worse, you know, getting in, don't feel insulted or anything like that. Because, you know, I love all you guys. And I don't dislike you because you don't like a movie that I do like. But anyway, that shit's all behind us now. We're all brothers again, right? Brothers, the Force is with us. But we are not Jedi yet. But anyway, thanks for watching, everybody. I remain deeply hurt. And, you know, this video has brought up a lot of sad feelings. So I am going to retire to the closet, turn the light off, and stay in there for 30 years. Until then, the Force will be with you. Always.